Now, a warm good morning and warm welcome on my YouTube channel, our chemistry class. We are discussing about polymer science in MSc final year inorganic special, paper 7th B. Today's our topic is the end group analysis. The end group analysis is the chemical method used for the calculating of the number average molecular weight of polymer samples whose molecules contains reactive functional groups at one end or both end of the molecule. For example, we know the structure of the carboxyl terminated polybutadiene CTBB and hydroxyl terminated polybutadiene HTPB. These molecules have carboxyl or hydroxyl groups at their respective ends. Each molecule theoretically possesses two functional group. In other words, for every two functional group identified in the sample of the polymer, one molecule has to be present. We are already familiar with the term functionality used in polymer chemistry. It is defined as the number of reactive functional groups present each macromolecules. Thus, the functionality of the HTPB and CTPB is 2, as each molecule possesses 2 reactive functional group. Apart from hydroxyl and the carboxyl, several other end group such as the aldehyde, amino ester and methyl can possibly be present. Usual chemical methods are employed to find out the total number of functional group present in the given weight of the sample, and this expressed as functional group equivalent upon 100 gram. From a knowledge of the functional group equivalent and the functionality, molecular weight can be calculated using this equation. Equation is this. For instance, the carboxyl value of CTPB can be determined by the dissolving a known quantity of the polymer in a mixture of toluene and the ethanol. Toluene is the 1 and ethanol is the 3. Ratio toluene ethanol is 1:3. And titrating against alcoholic potassium hydroxide. Titrate against alcoholic potassium KOH. The procedure is KOH. The procedure is the follows. Commercial grade ethanol is distilled and neutralized with a dilute solution of alcoholic potassium hydroxide. Mixture of ethanol and the toluene is made. A precisely weighted quantity less than 1 gram of the CTPB sample is dissolved in the ethanol toluene mixture. This is the titrated against the 0.1 normal alcoholic potassium hydroxide solution using phenolphthalein as a indicator. Here we use indicator as phenolphthalein. Phenolphthalein indicator used because acid base reaction. Acid is the alcoholic and the base is the alcoholic KOH. The end point of the appearance of the slightly in pink color. Let the volume of the KOH is VML. Normality KOH is the N. And weight of the sample taken W gram. Now carboxyl value is VN 56.1 upon W milligram of KOH per gram. Then carboxyl equivalent per 100 gram is equal to VN 56.1 upon W upon 1000 into 100 upon 56.1 is equal to V upon 10 W. It is a particular measurement. If 0.8734 gram of the sample has
consumed 5.1 ml of the 0.1242 normal alcoholic potassium hydroxide solution, then carboxyl equivalent per 100 gram 5.1 into 0.1242 upon 0 into 0.8734 is equals to 0.0725. Assuming a functionality of the two up to, we get m bar n is equals to molecular weight 2 into 100 upon 0.0725 is equals to 2760. The end group of analysis method can be used reliably only for sample containing consisting of linear molecule with determinable end group, and for those obtained a non polymerization mechanism with outside reaction. This is because side reaction during polymerization may introduce error in the assumed functionality and hence lead to erroneous result. The functionality is the molecular weight into functional equivalent. The next topic is the viscometry. Viscometry is an useful technique for determining the polymer molecular weight. The molecular weight obtained by this technique is viscosity average molecule weight m bar v. The viscosity of a polymer solution considerably highly prepared to the pure solvent. The increase of viscosity separated by the macromolecules in solution is the direct function of the thermodynamic volume and hence the molecular weight of the macromolecules. We are already familiar with different relationship between the viscosity of a polymer solution and the molecular weight. The next section, this section will sell reciprocal only famous Mark-Hoving equation. This is the important equation. Mark-Hoving equation is this. This is the Nita is show for viscosity and Km bar E, where Nita is the viscosity, intrinsic viscosity, and m bar is the molecular weight, and a k is the constant for a particular polymer sample or temperature system. K and a values are available for many of the non polymers. Some such values are given in table. For a polymer types of the known k and a values, what is required to the determination of the intrinsic viscosity and computation of the molecular weight using above equation. For an unknown polymer system, the K and A values have to be generated. This is done by fractionating polymer sample into several fraction, and for each fraction and molecular weight is determined by osmometry. Or by the light scattering techniques, and the corresponding intrinsic velocity are also measured. Typical data are given in table. Log plot of Nita against m bar molecular weight given. Data
Given a straight line to shown the figure ordinate intercept slope of this, the will give K and A positively for the data given in table. K and A values are 8.630 into 10 to power minus 5 dl per gram and 0.725 A value. The molecular weight and viscosity data for the polymethyl acrylate sample in benzene solution at 30 degrees centigrade. The fraction number is 1, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the fraction number. And molecular weight m bar n into 10 is to power minus 5 is this, and the neta value is this. Now in figure, this is the molecular weight and this is the neta. We find a straight line. Now straight line, this is the straight line neta and m bar, and this is the neta m bar, and this is the neta graph plot by this, and we find a straight line. Now let us see how intrinsic velocity can be measured. Assume that liquid flowing through a capillary tube, the time required for the liquid volume V to pass through the capillary of the radius R and length is L related to the absolute viscosity neta by the famous Poiseuille equation. Neta is equal to 3.14 pi r 4t upon 8 vl. This is the equation. Then t is equal to 8 v l neta. Suppose 3.14 pi r 4, where p is the pressure head under which the liquid flow take place. In above equation, thus correlated the flow time with the absolute viscosity of the liquid. If neta and neta 0 are the absolute viscosity of a solution and the pure solvent respectively, and T 0 are there, corresponding flow times can derive following relationship. Neta and neta 0, T and T 0. T is equals to 8 VL upon 3.14 PR square neta, and this is the T0. On T0, T0 is equals to, T is equals to neta, and T0 is equals to also neta 0. For the same capillary tube, the quantities within present parenthesis have been same value, hence deriving equation above equation. T is equal to neta and T is equal to neta 0, then T upon T 0 is equal to neta upon neta 0. This is the important solution of above equation. The term neta upon neta 0 is known as the relative viscosity. The term neta and upon neta 0 known as the relative viscosity. This term and other term related to viscosity measurement is given follow. Relative viscosity is the neta upon neta 0 is equal to T upon T 0, and specific velocity is the this, and reduced velocity is this, and inherent viscosity and intrinsic viscosity. Intrinsic viscosity is also known as the Stronger index or limiting viscosity number. एज स्पेसिफिक विस्कोसिटी इज बाय द डेफिनेशन डायमेंशनल एक क्वांटिटी. द इंट्रिंसिक विस्कोसिटी हैज रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ कंसंट्रेशन एज डायमेंशन. इट मे बी नोटेड फ्रॉम द अबोव डिस्कशन दैट फॉर द कैलकुलेटिंग द इंट्रिंसिक विस्कोसिटी ऑफ ए पॉलीमर सैंपल इन सॉल्यूशन वी नीड नॉट नो द एब्सोल्यूट विस्कोसिटी ऑफ द सॉल्वेंट एंड द सॉल्यूशन बट ओनली द फ्लो टाइम ऑफ द कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम एंड सॉल्वेंट एंड द सॉल्यूट सिस्टम पर्टिकुलर कैपिलरी ट्यूब एंड द प्रिंसिपल यूज्ड द विस्कोमीटर टेक्निक ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूलर वेट डिटरमाइनिंग. इन द एक्चुअल एक्सपेरिमेंट सॉल्यूशन ऑफ नॉन कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द पॉलीमर सैंपल आर मेड द सॉल्वेंट फ्लो टाइम टी जीरो एंड द सॉल्यूशन फ्लो टाइम टी. द डिफरेंट कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ द मेजरमेंट यूजिंग द सेम विस्कोमीटर फॉर कंसंट्रेशन करेस्पॉन्डिंग द इंट्रो रिड्यूस्ड विस्कोसिटी टू द इनहेरेंट विस्कोसिटी ऑफ कैलकुलेटिंग. नेक्स्ट दिस इज द फिगर कंसंट्रेशन वर्सेज नीटा एंड दिस इज द टेबल टेबल हैविंग कंसंट्रेशन एंड फ्लो टाइम. डबल एक्स्ट्रा पोलटेनस प्लॉट रिड्यूस विस्कोसिटी अगेंस्ट कंसंट्रेशंस इनहेरेंट विस्कोसिटी अगेंस्ट कंसंट्रेशंस आर प्रिपेयर्ड कॉमन ऑर्डिनेट इंटरसेप्ट देयर ग्राफ्स गिवन इंटरेस्टिंग विस्कोसिटी द डेटा एंड द प्लॉट्स टिपिकल मेजरमेंट आर गिवन इन द टेबल वो टेबल ऑफ ऑल द मेथड्स अवेलेबल फॉर द मॉलिक्यूलर वेट डिटरमिनेशन. पॉलीमर विस्कोसिटी मेजरमेंट may be least complex and the most convenient. The solution viscosity of the polymer are determining by the viscometer, the Ostwald viscometer and the unbelievable the U below standard level viscometer USLV and Ostwald. This is the Ostwald and this is the Ostwald. And this is the USLV अब below suspended level viscometer. Two type of the viscometer seen here. Generally we seen Ostwald viscometer but here is USLV also are the two popular viscometers in this diagram as can be seen from the figure. These viscometer are simple glass capillary devices. While using the Ostwald viscometer, care must be taken to see that all the measurements are made using a constant volume of the solution. Otherwise, the effective pressure head will vary from the solution in another and the equation. This we no longer be applicable however in the UPSLV USLV the design is such as the measurement of the unaffected by the volume and solution taken. The main advantage of the USLV is that only the main advantage of USLV that only a single solution of known concentration is required to the med to start with. A known volume of this solution is taken in the viscometer and the flow time measured. Subsequent concentration can be achieved by adding known volume of pure solvent and mixing inside the viscometer itself. This in turn yield sufficient data computing flow times different concentrations. In contrast to that, the experimental procedure with respect to the Ostwald viscometer is a rather tedious as each time we have the empty clean and refill and viscometer with the fresh solution before measuring the flow time. टू गेट रिप्रोड्यूसिबिलिटी रिजल्ट विद आइदर ऑफ दीज विस्कोमीटर सर्टेन प्रिकॉशंस आर एब्सोल्यूटली इसेंशियल एज द विस्कोसिटी इज हाईली डिपेंड ऑन टेम्परेचर ऑल मेजरमेंट्स शुड बी डन एट द कॉन्स्टेंट टेम्परेचर विद इन प्लस माइनस 0.01 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड द विस्कोमीटर शुड बी सो माउंटेड एज होल्ड द कैपिलरी परफेक्टली वर्टिकल ऑल द टाइम एज अदरवाइज इवन विद द सम वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन द प्रेशर हेड विल वारी अनदर सोर्स ऑफ एरर लाइज द मेजरमेंट ऑफ द फ्लो टाइम फॉर ए पर्टिकुलर वॉल्यूम ऑफ द सॉल्यूशंस और सॉल्वेंट मस्ट बी सफिशियंटली लॉन्ग so that the difference in flow time between two successive concentrations is at least of the order of 3 to 5 seconds. All stainless should be free from such present impurities as otherwise the latter may obstruct the free low solution within the capillary leading to erroneous flow line. Okay students, next lecture in our class R chemistry class. Continues watching my online lecture and prepare your notes by help of PDF and complete your assignment which is given by me day by day. Okay, your bright future. Thank you so much.